On the 12th of November in 1815, Elizabeth Cady was born and raised in this house in Johnston, New York. She would later marry Henry Brewster Stanton and have 7 children. Elizabeth Cady Stanton was a writer, abolitionist, social activist, women's rights activist, and a suffragist. In 1848, Elizabeth Cady Stanton helped organize the first women's rights convention that was held in Seneca Falls, New York, where Stanton lived. At the convention, Elizabeth presented her Declaration of Sentiments, where she declared that men and women are created equal. She proposed, among other things, that there should be voting rights for women and that women should demand the equal station to which they are entitled. In her closing remarks, Stanton stated, quote, "Now, in view of this entire disenfranchisement of one half of the people of this country, their social and religious degradation, in view of the unjust laws above mentioned, and because women do feel themselves aggrieved, oppressed, and fraudulently deprived of their most sacred rights, we insist that they have immediate admission to all the rights and privileges which belong to them as citizens of these United States," unquote. In 1851, Elizabeth Cady Stanton was introduced to fellow suffragist and women's rights activist Susan B. Anthony. The two became fast friends and would remain so for 50 years. Anthony soon became the organizer and tactician of the women's movement, while Stanton wrote many of Anthony's speeches. In 1866, Stanton, Anthony, and several other suffragists drafted a universal suffrage petition. The petition demanded that the right to vote be given to everyone without consideration of sex or race. In 1869, Stanton and Anthony founded the National Woman Suffrage Association. Elizabeth served as president for over 20 years. This organization would later merge with the popular American Woman Suffrage Association, creating the National American Woman Suffrage Association, in which Stanton served as the first president. In 1881, along with Susan B. Anthony and Matilda Jocelyn Gage, Elizabeth Cady Stanton wrote the first volume of History of Woman's Suffrage, which turned out to be a 6-volume series with a very detailed history of the woman suffrage movement. In 1892, Elizabeth joined other suffragists in addressing the United States House Committee on the Judiciary. Stanton told them, quote, "The strongest reason for giving women all the opportunities for higher education, for the full development of their faculties, her forces of mind and body, for giving her the most enlarged freedom of thought and action, a complete emancipation from all forms of bondage, of custom, dependence, superstition, from all the crippling influences of fear, is the solitude and personal responsibility of her own individual life," unquote. It was the last time Stanton would address Congress. Elizabeth Cady Stanton died on October 26, 1902, at the age of 86, 18 years before women were granted the right to vote. In a tribute that appeared in the New York Times, Susan B. Anthony said that Stanton, quote, "forged the thunderbolts," unquote, that Anthony had fired. You can read more about Elizabeth Cady Stanton in her autobiography, 80 Years and More, or view the movie The Story of Elizabeth Cady Stanton and Susan B. Anthony by PBS. Elizabeth Cady Stanton is just one of hundreds of women featured in our 2012 Celebrate Women calendar, which can be purchased for $5 plus $1.50 shipping and handling from the Office of Peace, Justice, and Integrity of Creation. For more information, please visit our website.